Hello, all. I'm Mitja Mori. I'm coming from Laboratory for Heat and Power, University of Ljubljana, Faculty of Mechanical Engineering. Today, I want to present you the results of the research that we did in the Plastike project with all the partners that I want to thank also about life cycle assessment of grocery bags. Because we are in those days talking a lot about bioplastic, I also address the title here, Opportunity of Biodegradable Plastics. You will see why, because the biodegradable plastic, you will see, have opportunity to implement into the, plastic world or manufacturing technique. But it has some advantages and also some disadvantages. I want to show here what those are, and I want to stress them out. So if we go through the agenda of my presentation, first, the scope of the study, then the starting point and methodology, because by the LCA assessment, you should be very careful how you define your study. Always you come at the end to some results, but are these results qualitative? Are they showing something? The basic thing is that you have to define the problem at the beginning, at the very beginning, so that you are then going further from the beginning to the end as planned. The third thing that is also big importance is limitations and boundary conditions of this numerical model. The biggest and the most important part is inventory analysis. So what are all materials, all other flows like water and all the processes used in this case? So the case here is grocery bag. And this inventory analysis should be done very very much in details. As I said, perhaps this is at the end, this brings good or bad results. I will show briefly just numerical models that were modeled in Gabi 5 software of PE International. I will go through this model just briefly because more in detail we don't have the time, but I want to show them. Of course, by the LCA, we are talking about some results. These results we get via indicators. Environmental indicators. There are a lot of methodologies, a lot of indicators that can be used, which were used here, we will show in point six. Of course, main thing, results and analysis from different point of view, from different life stages, because there are more life stages in one technology life cycle. At the end, conclusions and recommendations and basic measures that has to be taken in by manufacturers, by us consumers, that we will show. It's the biggest part that influences the life cycle of the grocery bag, because the intention of the grocery bags is, of course, to use for shopping. And here, shopping is done by the us consumers. So waste management that plays a key role in the process, it's the somehow waste management is because of the consumers and how we react to certain situations. First, the scope and target audience. We have to define this. What is the scope of the study? We had three plastic grocery bags, and we took LDPE. low-density polyethylene plastic bag as a basic, because with that we compared all other results. The methodology is life cycle assessment, as I already said, from cradle to grave. So we are modeling the whole life cycle of the technology. We defined specific indicators that will shown and explained later. We did at the beginning basic scenarios. What that means, we have one basic scenario, and then at the end we will show some variation. What that means, let's say waste management, what if we put the grocery bag instead of yellow linear bin to the black linear bin? How this affects environmental impact through different indicators. Target audience, we can define several groups. Bag producers or manufacturers are the first. We will show some recommendations for them, but they are very logical recommendations. Then, of course, customers. This is the basic thing that has to be changed in the future, because without cooperation of the customers to properly manage with waste, this environmental impact could be even worse. Then waste management companies. In Slovenia, what I was confronted with was that there are no real data on which can I rely about waste management. What is the percentage of overall wastes that goes to the incineration? What is the percentage that goes to landfill? And not just overall waste management, but mixed one, but what about plastic? How much is recycled, etc. And nevertheless, at the end, is always the policy makers that should also get should we also get some attention. So, because the changes should be done from there first. If we go through these grocery bags that were included in the study, behind that is the system Mercator that also I have to thank to, because they provide a lot of data from the production process of these grocery bags, and also Plasta as a main player on this industrial area in Slovenia. I also have to thank to, because they gave me the real data from their manufacturing procedure. And these are the three bags that were included in the study, their technical characteristics. You can see that we are going from, I brought this bag with me. This is the basic bag. It's 14.8 grams, 16.2 liters. This is one low density polyethylene. Then it's the bag for life, how it's called. Prospected lifetime should be around 5 years according to manufacturer, we will see that that's the best pick for shopping. Why, we will see later. Of course, this bag weighs a bit more. It's 1 to 7 grams, so if we compare them one to one, we should question ourselves what the results will be. And at the end, we have this biodegradable bag. It's from starch, from corn. That is not actually produced in Plasta yet for the Mercator system, but they intend to produce it in the future. So this is just a sample, but the thing was calculated in such a manner that the volume was the same as the basic model, but here is a bit of assumption, but assumption not from me, but from the company Plasta, how much material it should be given into this bag, because by biodegradable materials, as I was taught, the problem is mechanical characteristics, and it should be used for the same volume, a bit more material. So that's why here the mass is a bit higher. As I said, LCA methodology was used, Gabi 5, okay, we just upgraded to 6, that's why it's here 5, 6, and from cradle to grave. And what is the most important on this slide is functional unit. It's one grocery bag. Perhaps I know that this is not the best approach because you can see the difference in masses. But nevertheless, it is one approach that can be done, but we have to then, at the end, when the analyses are done, it should be analyses in the different approach. If we had also the information how we customers behave during the shopping, so how many articles we put into the bags, how many bags we actually used during the month. The actual functional unit should be number of items bought within the months. And then we should calculate back how many grocery bags, according to their volume, we are using in that month. If we would use one bag just one time. And we have then reference flow. And then we could compare these results. This is perhaps the thing for the future. But we have to determine how customers behave in Slovenia. Because all the data that I managed to get is for European Union or New Zealand or Australia or other countries. But I don't think this is applicable to Slovenia. This is the basic scheme of our life cycle model. Production of basic materials, then we should transport these basic materials to the manufacturer, then is production of grocery bags, partly in Slovenia, partly in Vietnam. Long life plastic bag is produced in Vietnam. Then it's packing and transport, utilization of grocery bag that is actually environmental neutral because we didn't model this in. Then, of course, reuse of grocery bags. We have primary use, secondary reuse. We will see that later what this is. Then part of these bags is recycled bag. This is mechanical recycle done by the manufacturer of the bags. And, of course, part goes to landfill, part composting, and here is missing incineration. Part goes to the incineration. The third one should also be added here in the next corrected picture. Of course, in this we have input. These are the boundaries of our system, and the input are basic sources and water. Basic sources are material, electricity, or some key basic sources, and what we want to get at the end, emissions to air and emissions to soil and waters through different indicators. Because of lack of information, and also because that LCI methodology lets us to cut off some mass flows that are below 5% in the overall mass, we had to do some cut-off criteria because some materials were not in the database, but nevertheless we can get also the data from different bases, and then at the end of analysis put them together, but we couldn't. We couldn't, so inks and dyes and titanium dioxide was put out of the system. They are in small amounts and they are used in all bags, so we assume that that is not really something that really relatively between each other influence the end results. Then, of course, storehouse activity, because there are people, there are some trucks in the storehouses, but you cannot model this. Then transport from store to customers and back, if we are reusing the grocery bags. Then the build-up of industrial power plants, that is a long a lifetime of industrial power plant, it's too long to implement that into the model. All auxiliary materials used in power plants, human labor, and all auxiliary activities. If we go to inventory analysis and we go to the basic materials, we use low-density polyethylene for LDPE bag, then polypropylene virgin for polypropylene bag, and MATER-B, biodegradable material that is from cornstarch that we use in the MATER-B bag. So, what is here? Packing materials, because what was included also in this study was also all the cardboard used, because this cardboard is used for packing. Then different number of bags are put into this cardboard boxes, and cardboard boxes at the end also goes into waste management system, so it should be modeled. Palette was modeled just in the sense of lifting the overall mass during the transport, because the palette was not recyclable, but it was returned back and used many times, so it could be let out of the system. At the beginning, because here I want to stress some pro et contra about biodegradable materials, I also looked at the comparison about polypropylene, low density polyethylene, and MATER-B biodegradable materials. We compare them kilo by kilo by kilo, because you saw that it is the difference in the mass in these bags. So at the beginning, just the material. And what we saw, the model is cradle to door, so the door is the door of the manufacturer. And MATER-B here seems very competitive. So we should stress this out. We can see that it uses less energy demand, energy for the production. The water goes up according to, you know, we are using starch from the corn, so we need water to that corn grows. But what we didn't implement here is this number. Global warming potential. So much of CO2 is absorbed during the growth of this corn. So if we put 0.93 away from 2, we get global warming potential a bit above 1. What shows us that in this indicator, MATER-B is very competitive. I didn't put this number in because I don't have the numbers for all other indicators, so just for one indicator, because CO2 is absorbed during the growth of the plant. So what we can conclude here, MATER-B in the production phase of the granulate is very competitive. Of course, the thing that what was a surprise also for me, that Mater B and all, I suppose, also all other biodegradable granulates or materials have, I won't stress out as a problem, but contra effects in later stages of life cycle. Here we can show that if we produce the same volume of bag out of LDPE or Mater B, the energy used in the production phase in the Mater B case is a bit higher than this one. Here we don't have all the data. This is this data and this diagram is from Plasta company, so it's very in detail. Here we have the bag of the recycling, and this is the extrusion of plastic, and this is the making of these grocery bags out of this. And every thing here takes some energy. If we go further with the inventory analysis, so now we done the production of the granulate, we done the manufacturing of the bag, now we go to the transport. Here is one transport case of the low-density polyethylene bag and Mater B bag, so produced in the Plasta company in Sint-Rupert. So it's not so much kilometers here in the equations, in the equation, and actually the transport is done with the Euro 5 truck, so it's very good, the lowest emission possible. We have the biggest impact comes from the they are getting the granulate LDPE from Linz and Mater B from Terni, Italy. So these are 500 and 800 kilometers, but all other transport routes are very short. But if we go to the next PP life, grocery bag, what we can see that here transport will probably have a big impact in the end result. What that means, we have cargo overseas to get the granulate to the factory. Then it's the small transportations port, factory port. Then the bags are going to Europe, to Trieste. Then from Trieste to the Ljubljana, where the storehouse is, and a part of these bags goes to the Ptuj storehouse. So the transport route is longer, and all the impacts out of this will be shown later. Then we have end. We did transport now, then we proceed to the end life scenarios. These are the end life scenarios that can be used in this study. So landfill, incineration, composting, and mechanical recycling. Mechanical recycling is used in first two grocery bags, so LDPE and PP life. Polypropylene and low-density polyethylene. But Mater B, here mechanical recycling is possible, but how we can make up the system to make this possible, that we get these bags back. So composting just in Mater B material, and incineration landfill in all cases, but the impact will be different. So if we go now step by step by this different waste management scenarios, we can have landfill. It was taken for European Union average. Why? Because we don't have the specific data for Slovenia. So it is about 14% goes to incineration and the rest goes to the landfill. What it should be stressed out that what is included into the study is that we have by the landfill of solid waste, we have some environmental credits, we have electrical energy production on site from the landfill gas. So this is implemented into the model. I know that all the landfills doesn't have this installed, but nevertheless here it's modeled like this. And mess, okay, 43% of grocery bags go to landfill because 50% goes back to the mechanical recycling. So this bag, long life, and this bag, low density polyethylene bag, in both is 50% recycled material that goes back to manufacturer. By this mechanical recycling, what we should include into the model is electrical energy used for grinding these bags. So that should be included. Then incineration. Incineration also for European Union average. Environmental credits here is heat and electricity. And what I should also say in this stage is that not just the bags here were put into the incineration and into recycling and into landfill, but also this cardboard boxes also. At the end of this chain, the cardboard boxes from shops are put into waste management and they are treated as all other things. Okay, just paper, not as plastic, but some part goes to the recycling, some part goes to the landfill, some part goes to the incineration. And we have some credits from this paper incineration, and this is the life cycle, but this paper and cardboard box is there because of the grocery bag. So it should be put into the model. Then composting. Composting is based on the literature. And by composting, I was surprised that all these boxes that we use for the compost that we have in the street, the brown ones, goes to the industrial composting. So industrial composting is in the term of energy consumption, also not really low energy consumer, because for the transportation, compost from the street to the industrial composting facility, we need diesel fuel and diesel and electricity consumption on site. So because composting is done by high temperatures and we need all the fans to transport the air inside for good conditions that should be there. And this we consume electricity and diesel fuel. And by the composting process, I was taught, CO2 and ammoniac emissions are present. So it affects environment. What is not good in the composting relative to landfill and incineration is that we have no environmental credits in industrial composting. But if we have home compost, these credits can be gained because this opportunity comes from home composting. So some kind avoids all the artificial fertilizers by using home compost. And here is also the for the first generation of bioplastics is the opportunity, because it can be used as a fertilizer after it biodegrades. Now just quickly through numerical models, put up in the Gabi software. We can see here the matter B case. This is the base case. So here is the data from the Novamont. I should thank also the Novamont company because they were very cooperative to give us the data, because this data is not inside Gabi software, and we have to do this analysis out of the Gabi software. So the model is put together of two models somehow. This was done by Novamont company, and this was done then after by us. Yellow are the materials, green are the transport, blue one is the production of the bag, and at the end this one is the end life scenario, because the base case for the matter B is just composting case, and all gray one is not included in the study, but nevertheless they are there. And it should be very specifically said what was not included. This is the polypropylene life bag. So also a bit more parts in the this numerical model. More transport to the end shop. And basic scenario at the end of life is 14% to incineration, 68% to landfill, but nevertheless this is just from the 50% of mass of the bag, because 50% goes back to mechanical recycling. Here goes half, and here goes half back to the recycling, because 50% of recycled material is used in the production process in Vietnam, in this case. And after this, every part of this numerical model, there are a lot of data, masses of the materials, water, then there are electricity, after the transport is different kind of transport, Euro 1 to Euro 5, then different consumptions of the diesel because of that, and this different emissions to the surrounding. So actually this is just the model on the very top, but beneath that all the complex data are hidden. And this is the low density polyethylene as a basic case, this bag here, and in the same manner as all two already presented. At the beginning, we should also define what we will research, what environmental indicators will be used in the case. And these are, let's say, the seven indicators used in this study. Why? Good question. There are some missing by the CML 2001 method. And they are missing because from Novamont we got some data of their material. And we just looked up to this data, and this were the data that we got from them. And if you want to compare something, because in absolute sense, LCA, I don't think, almost never gives the results that can be very much in detail compared with other studies. But within the study, relatively, LCA study gives us the result that we can compare very much in the detail. And so we put all other three factors that should indicators that should be in this CML 2001 out of this out of this study, and we also assumed and studied that these three indicators are so small that these are the basic that should be take into account, took into account. And the most popular one is global warming potential. This is the most popular one, and from this one we can get somehow the result how much energy is used in one technology or one process. And here is just the case how this global warming potential between different gases is. For the carbon dioxide is GVP1, and if we have methane, it's 25 times more through this indicator. So, and all other things even more. So if we have the emissions of NOxes, That means that we will have a really big impact on the global warming potential indicator. So that is how it works. And now, finally, because we did from steps to step, from the materials to production to transport and end life scenarios, here are the first results. And what we see here on the absolute scale, we have plastic bag versus plastic bag versus plastic bag. And of course, the most environmentally unfriendly here is PP life bag, but that's not logical. Yes, of course, the mass here is more than 100 grams use of granulate, and later we will see that granulate is the biggest impact in the life cycle. So here it's the impact on the results here. Here is Materbi bag that is surprisingly through global warming potential more harmless to environment than low density polyethylene bag. But if we look this diagram, we can see the contribution of different stage lifestyle, life cycle phases on the whole result. This is 100%. And we can see that in low density polyethylene bag, it's almost 70% comes out of the production of the basic granulate. That in, let's say, polypropylene life bag, it's big impact of the transport as we expected that it would be, and also from the granulate. But what is surprisingly that a big impact in the Materbi bag comes from the end life scenario. As I already said, there are no environmental credits from industrial composting, and it consumes, industrial composting consumes energy. That's why here the burden is big. Here the burden would also be bigger if there would be no environmental credits. So no electricity and no heat produced, because this electricity heat we to take these two, take them back at the beginning where they are used in the proper manner, and the burden goes down. Now we go to the break-even analysis. That means how many times the bag should be used to meet the global warming potential of the basic bag, that is low density polyethylene bag. And polypropylene bag, just 14 times. Nevertheless, that the mass is almost 10 times bigger. And surprisingly, Materbi two times. That is not logical here. So at the beginning, we showed that the granulate, if we compare them kilo to kilo, Materbi is very, very competitive, very good. But these later stages of the life cycle, of the whole life cycle, are working contra the idea of this biodegradable materials. But we will show in the next slides how this also can be put out, and that biodegradable plastic have the future. This is the environmental indicators of the matter be relatively, this is depletion potential, acidification potential, eutrophication potential, global warming potential, and so on. We can see that in almost all cases, the production of the basic granulate is the biggest impact. Just in the global warming potential is the contra. This end-life scenario is working contra. Why? Because global warming potential, you know, this is in CO2 equivalents. That means, and what I said before is that CO2 is in this industrial composting facility is goes out to the environment. And also ammonia goes out, that is through global warming potential means a lot of burden to environment, goes up. So just global warming potential is here like the problem, let's say. It is not, but all others, the contribution, relatively speaking, comes just from the granulate. But we showed before that granulate is very competitive if we compare them versus polypropylene and low-density polypropylene. So just global warming potential. But what is not good that is that in by all the us consumers, global warming potential is the most popular indicator, and we should interpret also from different point of view our results. This is polypropylene lifetime back, and we can see the green color comes from the transport. Relatively, it comes a lot from the transport, as is also to be assumed, because the bag is produced in Vietnam. So my suggestion would be to move this bag to the Europe, or better, to Slovenia. It is some impact from the granulate, more or less, and of course manufacturing. The impact from manufacturers is manufacturing of the bags is just through electricity consumed. So this is the main. But electricity in the terms of environmental impacts, if we know that in Slovenia is 30-30-30, it's big. Because we have nuclear, we have some renewables, one-third, and we have classical power plants on the coal-fired, and if we produce electricity, at the end, the electricity have a big impact on the environment. And this is from low-density polyethylene. You can see here that the green color is not present. Why? Because transport is not a burden, because Schentrupert is very near Ljubljana and also Ptuj, if we compare to the Vietnam. Here below, minus values means that these are the credits that we get out of the different life cycle stages. And some parameters, indicators have these credits, some don't. If we go now further to the results and we compare back versus back versus back. We can see here, we already showed through global warming potential indicator that the PP life back should be the worst case because of its mass. But that is just to show the results, but this result should be interpreted differently. What we also see is that matter B here is inferior to LDPE if we compare them directly. Something is also according to mass different. Something is according to industrial composting that we already explained. Industrial composting also have no environmental credits, but by LDPE back, there are environmental credits through incineration and through landfill gas. But now, theoretically, we are speaking hypothetically, theoretically, what if the bags would be equal mass? Equality means that we get competitiveness of Mater B bag. It's very competitive to all other bags. It is a bit worse, but we should stress out here, composting is included. If we put home composting in, this would be, in this case, winning case. That are the facts. Through global warming potential, equality of mass is that low-density polyethylene is the worst case if we go through with indicator that is the most popular. Then, what about GVP of matter B? Let's say potential. What is the potential here of matter B material? In this case, it's also some theoretical approach because I don't have the data of home composting process. But if we just put the industrial composting out, so we have no credits, but we have also no burn. We get that through global warming potential indicator, matter B bag is, nevertheless, the mass is bigger. We can compare this to low-density polyethylene. Of course, this is here the worst case because of its mass. It's more than 100 grams. And also here we can see that if we put this end-of-life scenario, industrial composting out, that it is very comparative to low-density polyethylene. We can see the same portion of granulate herein. We can say almost the same portion of production process and a bit more of the transport because this granulate comes from Linz, this comes from Terni. Terni is a bit far away. So this is the potential that matter B has. Then we go further because we now have or we got through base scenarios. But now we can have what if. What if we reuse the bag? And with that, I mean primary reuse, so we reuse the bag for shopping again. That should be done. And that also could be done. And secondary reuse, when the bag is a few times primary reused, we use them as bin liner. So we use them for all other wastes and put them in the black liner bin. And that is something that is also potential to lower the impacts, but it's not the thing of the consumers and not the thing of the producers, manufacturers of the granulate, but it's the thing to be done by us consumers, not by the producers of the granulate and not from the producers of the bags. So the consumers here comes into the equation or into the system of the life cycle assessment model. And by this, primary reuse means that the reduction of environmental burdens goes down proportionally. So two times less environmental impact, etc. Secondary reuse is somehow more complicated because we assumed that by bin liner, we did separate LCA model, but it was the same, just different masses and different electricity consumptions. 50% of materials is assumed to be used for these bin liners. The same production process And one-time use. We use just bin liner, as a bin liner, this bag one time. We fill the wastes in, we put them out, so it's one-time use. But the reduction of environmental burdens in average is for 14% for low-density polyethylene bag and a bit more for Mater B bag. Mater B bag should be used for biodegradable wastes, not for mixed wastes. So, because it should be put into the bin, into a linear bin that is used for all this compostable thing out of our kitchen. And we have this waste management scenarios. Base scenario is here. In all three cases, for Mater B 100% composting at the end, for this and this bag is the same 50% recycling, mechanical recycling back to the manufacturer of the bag, then 7% of overall mass to the incineration, and 43% to landfill. So this is the baseline scenario. Then of course, what if protocol can go on? What if we had 100% of mechanical recycling? That can be done theoretically here. But of course, manufacturer, I don't know, I don't have the data if this could be done. It means that environmental burdens goes down. That is the thing that we are showing here in the model. Then if we put all the waste, that means this 50%, in the landfill. Then in other case, all this 50% to incineration. These are two, you know, end cases. And this too can be done in both three cases. But composting in this few two cases cannot be done. As said, two baseline scenario, all the variations were done. And if we go through these results quickly, mechanical recycling is good. Here is base scenario. This is zero recycling. This is 100% recycling. This is all in the landfill and nothing in incineration. This is nothing in landfill and 50% incineration. And of course, 50% recycling in these two cases. What is good is that environmental burden goes down if 100% of recycling is done. I don't know if this is technically possible. But nevertheless, it's a theoretical case. Now, if we put everything what we don't mechanically recycle to landfill, some parameters goes up, some down, so some stays almost the same. So we can, here is worst case, worst case, worst case, a bit of better case. Why? Because we have these environmental credits that we get from landfill via electricity. Then here is also worst case. So it's somehow we can conclude it's the case is worse in that scenario. Then this scenario, if we put everything in incineration, global warming potential goes up. Why? Because all the emissions are put into environment immediately by the incineration process. Why this goes down? Because we have environmental credits and we produce heat and electricity, and this is how it shows. Then for Mater B bag, we have less scenarios because base is 100% compostable. Then we have 100% landfill and 100% incineration. And what we have here is The credits are included. I will stress this many times because these credits in the model, I will also show later, perhaps it should be taken out. And that should be also look up in the future, how this influences the model. Also by incineration, credits are included. If we just compare this composting and out of the literature to this incineration process, is somehow the same impact if we are talking with no credits, of course. And then when you add by the incineration process the credits, so the incineration somehow is better, but I don't know if this is also the case. Here, 100% landfill, some stays the same, some go worse, and by the incineration, some goes a bit down, but nevertheless, it's staying in the same range. They stay in the same range. Then, I spoke before that I don't have the data of the how customers behave in the shops and how many articles they buy, so you cannot get the real reference flow. But what we did is on some data from the Mercator system and from the governmental data, how many bags per month on the households is really used, really. And this is somewhere the case. And what I should stress out, all reuses, all long life bags, all new board bags are included into this number. So it is one mixture of everything. So, and if we put the lifetime of 5 years, this is the lifetime of this bag, polypropylene, long life bag. If we calculate how many low density polyethylene or Materbi bags is used and just one bag versus that number of bags is used on this side, we can then from these numbers calculate the impacts on the environment. And of course, here the superiority of this bag comes out because 50 to 100% times difference in almost all indicators is present and it's shown. So this is the case that the consumers should use this bag that can be used many times. And if I just proceed with the conclusions. The conclusions are for manufacturers. So enlarge the share of recyclate, regenerate, as much as possible, of course. This is the technical limitation here. Then, of course, energetic efficiency of the power plant they are dealing with, because they should use as little energy as they can to produce the bags. So with the electricity down, I suppose they are working in that direction because actually that means money for them. Then, of course, consumers. This is the biggest impact in the whole life cycle that can be changed in the future. So polypropylene life bag advantages, just 4 times use, primary reuse, the bag goes to the level of the basic low-density polyethylene bag. Then in 5 years, that is the lifetime of that bag, 41 times less GVP of low-density polyethylene. So, but these bags are more than 500 used in this 5 years time. Then reuse. Primary reuse means proportional reduction of impacts. Secondary reuse, of course, that means reduction of this impact on the environment, not proportional, but 40% in some cases of indicators. And it is more in low-density polyethylene case than in MATER-B case present, this reduction. But nevertheless, also for MATER-B case, the reduction is seen and is evident. Then how to consumers, how to properly dispose the bag? Because in our street, I can see every day improperly disposed thing, not just bags, but skip this case. These two bags should be put in yellow litter bin for all the plastic things. Then matter B should be put as the first alternative in the home compost, because this is the starch-based bag and can degrade in the home compost. And by that, we somehow avoids production of artificial fertilizer. So this is somehow environmental credit. Okay? And second alternative is brown litter bin, because this is for industrial composting. This is the second case, but not in the yellow litter bin. And what is perhaps the most important, not in the surrounding. So this bag, biodegradable bag, is not biodegradable so that we can just throw that away, but it should be done within the industrial or home compost facility. What means if the consumers are not behaving in the proper manner? That means inappropriate waste management. That means that low-density polyethylene bag in the black liner bin, in average 7% increasement of burdens to the environment. Then PP life bag in black liner bin, 3% of increasement of burdens, in average we are talking. And biodegradable bag in the black liner bin, that means GVP goes up around 13% because it's incinerated and a bigger part landfilled. Others are between 0 and 50% going up, so that is some averages. Basic recommendations heard many times, 3 times R. Reduce, reuse, and recycle. These are basic recommendations. So reduce the usage of this bag, so use the PP life bag, so this one. Then reuse as a primary use, secondary use, and also as bin liner in secondary reuse. And of course, recycle, that means that you properly put in the yellow bin or other for the matter B. And that means mechanical recycling back to the producer or manufacturer of the bag. And by manufacturer of the bag, the reduction of virgin materials as technical possible. But I think they are trying to do this all the time, because that means money. Further research. What should be done in further research in this case? First, I want to look if we exclude all environmental credits. Because, as I said, not all landfills have the facility for producing electricity. And perhaps if we put also out of our numerical model the credits of electricity and heat in incineration facility, what happens then according to different types of bags? Because as we see, the end life scenario is a really means really a big impact to overall picture. And of course, compare matter B with polylactic acid, that We bought the database and got all the data from PE International, so I have this in the Gabi. So I want to check what this material means versus matter B. But what should be stressed out that if matter B is some kind suitable for home composting, that in my by my information is not. That should be just industrial composted. So that is one limitation that this material has, that matter B doesn't have. And of course, relativity of results. One bag, low density polyethylene bag, in the whole life cycle means around 140 meters by the car, by average car. So sometimes it's better to walk to the shop and buy the grocery bag, not to drive to the other side of the city with this bag. So that should be took into consideration too. Thank you for your attention and questions, if there are any.